While the greediest games are very hard space shooters, the final boss of every game has been known quite infamously for one thing: sitting there and doing nothing. It's a tradition that began with the first game. But Konami didn't simply rest on their laurels, even the boss did. Ever since Konami decided to add small snippets of voice acting to the greediest games, the final bosses have had things to say. Important things. Let's listen to them. Gradius 2 was released only in Japan, for the arcade, and the Japanese version of the NES. The arcade version included a bit of voice acting for the game's final boss, a giant, nasty-looking head with exposed muscle tissue and brain matter, named Gopher. Yes, Gopher, pronounced like the animal. I wonder why they never released this game outside of Japan. You're the strongest, huh? The statement quickly becomes a self-demonstrating joke. Just observe. Having easily been killed through his attack strategy of just stand there and do nothing, Gopher, Gradius 2's goofily named final boss, feels a need to let out a taunt. I'm just a small force, the Empire Bacterian. Why are we afraid of the Empire Bacterian again? Because Gradius games are really hard, just not their final bosses. For the next game, the final boss is a giant head with visible brain matter. I'm already noticing a pattern here. His name is Bacterian. While they removed his voice in the Super NES version, he speaks in the arcade once killed.
I was born out of the greediness of mankind. While many live, so will I.
Okay, greediness? Don't you mean greed?
Greediness.
Also, this time Bacterian is saying that he's a product of people being greedy. So a simple human emotion spawned Bacterian into being? Oh, that makes sense. Well, I guess we'll all have to stop having selfish feelings, because as long as we do, a giant evil head with a brain inside is going to appear somewhere in the galaxy and attack planet Gradius. In Gradius Gaiden, for the original PlayStation, there are multiple bosses with voice acting. All the final boss does is assume various forms from the past, while repeating the exact same lines as the game's other bosses. But they are rather hammy lines. This line originally came from a giant Moai head. Oh no, a Moai called me a loser. Then his boss called me one too. This final boss, named Ovum, puts up slightly more of a fight than usual, but still mostly just a fancy visual show that tosses out random hammy one-liners. It's a bit goofy, but not as much as the next guy we're gonna check out. The arcade-only Gradius 4 brings back Gopher from Gradius 2, and he's got quite the ego on him. He'd like you to know that.
I'm the center of the universe. My will moves every living thing in this universe.
The self-proclaimed center of the universe hasn't yet learned the concept of offense, however. He seems to think they can intimidate you into fear by just sitting there and looking scary, depending on one's definition of scary, because look at this face. Once you kill him, he's quick to threaten you.
My body will be broken into pieces and spread across.
I love how Gopher's voice sounds like some random guy talking into a tin can. Gradius 5 hit the PlayStation 2. The final boss finally stopped being hammy and actually made more of an effort to sound menacing. Just listen to this surprisingly verbose speech. Wow. I was wondering how many different ways it's possible to say, haha, I'll come back to life and attack the universe again. But this guy has developed much more vocabulary this time around. Canonically, this is the final Gradius game, but there is one more made after this. After Castlevania and Contra got so-called Rebirth games from the Wii's Shop Channel, Konami decided to do a retro remake for Gradius as well. This one has more of a story, taking place before most of the previous games, and even having you take orders from someone named Dr. Venom. Wait, the same Venom as Gradius V's final boss? Uh-oh. Eventually you fight not Venom, but the Bacterian Leader, a giant brain in a glass tube, who greets you as the boss.
You can't beat me! Never!
Looks like when they went retro, they brought back the ham. I'm proud of you, Konami, or whoever you hired to do this retro remake for you. While Gradius' final boss has changed over the years, from giant brain to giant head to giant brain and giant head made of brain matter and all that, one thing that hasn't changed over the years, the final boss has always remained a pushover.